Thank you. I'm excited that you made it.
Yeah.
And I'm grateful for being here as well.
So my name is Oksana. I'm from Your Brightness Company. And I would like to talk today about decluttering as part of the staging, or staging is what we know and what is involved in the process. And it's hard to tell, but English is not my first language. So if you have something to ask, don't be shy, I'm okay. Don't ask your neighbor, what do you say? Just ask me, I'm fine, stop me, ask questions anytime you feel like that. I want to share that the staging today, what I learned, you don't have to convince your client that it's important. Before, like 20, 30 years ago, you had a house, I need a house, good enough, I'm buying the house. Today, the possibilities and expectations are higher, so we do need some sort of staging, and it's good to have it, and client understands the value more. They still want to spend less, most of them, but they do understand that they need it, some sort of staging. So this is what I would like to say, but staging also, you know, we will say staging, but it's just one word that we know, but how to get there and what is involved. And I also believe staging is just the final lipstick, you know, to look pretty, but there's so much, many petty hair and whatever to look good before that, before the picture. So I would like to stop more on that, and I will talk about decluttering and other preparations. So sometimes when I mention staging, it's a preparation process as well. So the facts that we all know and like and understand, this is home staging facts. Probably everybody who's been here told you that most buyers create the opinion about the house first 5-7 seconds. They know if they want to go through or it's enough, they saw everything. And also, seller who spent about $500 for staging, maybe cover 340%, and it's true, but it's about the staging. They have another numbers about decluttering preparation. So this is common fact. They are very useful. They are true 100%. I've been in the business for 7 years, and I believe it's the best investment you can make. The best investment. It's such a fast turnout of those money, and no bank can give it to you if you do it right. If you do it right.
Can I just make one comment?
Mm-hmm.
It's okay. So I've used her 3 times. She's great, and it doesn't have to be the whole place. It can be.
Yeah, it could be any place.
Rooms.
Yes, because also this is what is important. If you invest a dollar, you get a 4 quarters back. Maybe not go that way, right? If you invest a dollar, you get 2, 3, 4, even 5 back. Then maybe we should look into that. So sometimes in the house, it's worth staging. If it's a staging and furniture and everything, just the main floor and maybe master bedroom, then I would say stop it, don't go overboard because you don't need it. And sometimes we have to stage places, like we have a condo at Fort York. I don't know if you know the building. We have to put the bed, stage the place, just to prove that it's possible to live there and that it fit. In that condo, you cannot have Costco membership. You can't. You just can't. One toilet paper roll is max. Nothing will fit. Awkward shapes, big windows, but they do. You feel like there's still space behind. You see the lake and everything, but there's nothing. Honestly, I was suffocating there, and there's a long hall, and we couldn't get the table in. We have to open the side door, go through the cabinet, somehow closet, and roll it in. It just, I don't know, it's a big business coming, furniture for condos like that. So there is another way of staging. Nice, beautiful place, new, there's spotless, everything, but nobody will believe they will fit in there, right? So you have to show it to them. So put the office corner area, dining room, breakfast room, everything, and the bedroom, and Okay, what home staging principles are the most important? And I want to tell you that actually it's for buyers and the sellers, because sometimes buyer thinks differently as a seller. But those are, you will see more or less the same, very close, and on the high end. So on a scale of 1 to 7, people believe that removing personal items are a good things to do. Use rooms for intended purposes. I don't know if you saw bedroom in the dining area, we did. So better not to if you sell the house. Remove evidence of pets. Any pets. We have a house in Mississauga, it was a record house. They had a snake, they had a spider, they have two dogs, a cat, and something like a rat or most awkward shapes. So, and I'm not making it up, it's hard to make up, it's not true. And anything I say there, it's based on my experience. All picture I will show you, they're not copied from online or magazine. It's my picture, my work, and facts that really are in there. The only thing with any pictures I'm trying to present or use in my PowerPoint, I don't use houses that are still not closed or on the market. Those pictures I will not show it to you, but something that is done, and then it's fine. Show homes furnished, not empty. It's good, but sometimes there are cases that it's not necessary, and I will show it with pictures. And remove personal photographs, which is just for safety reasons. There's very little chance that the crazy people will walk through your house and you have your family and kids and they have the address and have your car number. It's just really not the way to go, I would say. But people are different. And the next one, home improvement facts. The research was done in Canada by Canadians, so I like that we can talk about here. I have nothing against this. most of the research comes from North America and you don't know where to fit it. But those are Canadian and I like it. So 72% of Canadians believe that decluttering is important, but they don't do it. 86% Canadian that conducting renovation is important. And they don't. Did you see the wobbly, light fixture and missing cover on light switcher and the railing that it's not in places and missing baseboards? They all understand it's kind of okay to have, it would be nice to have, but they're not rushing to do that. 86% believe that staging is important. 86. Oh, the first one is cluttering. Believe, but 61 of 86 don't do it. 62 Canadian home sellers are doing minimal maintenance because you really push them, guys. You have to, do something with your mailbox. And that's that people will kill themselves. Just do something. But 37% of home sellers in Ontario have the least trouble getting rid of stuff. 37. But we have 73 left that do have trouble to say goodbye to their collection of National Geographic magazines and basements. So this is what we are happy to have. So decisions. This is the real picture. I didn't make it up. I didn't Photoshop. It's a basement, apartment, kitchen. Get more money for less stuff. Be more but heavy. By having less. I believe it, I live by that, and I saw so many stories and houses. I can write, maybe one day I will write a book, that people have too much of what they need, what they might need one day. I personally came to Canada 14 years ago with 2 kids and 2 beds. I need a truck to get to move. And my kids moved out, they need a truck to move. We just grow, it grows around us. I don't know how and why we are so hungry to have more. And it doesn't make us better, we just have more. And then it costs us to get rid of that. So just get more money for less stuff when you sell. And when you live in that house, I will just preach, be more by having less. And then your mind will be not so cluttered as well. So if you have to make a decision, okay, we have a room. What do we do with that room? We have to sell the house. What do we do with that room? To me, the easiest way, But we cannot do it, right? We have to talk to the client and feel what do they feel about it. So I'm asking, do you like keep it? Maybe there's some garbage we might find and you might not need it? Or maybe you want to donate it, so, and that will help us to figure out, keep them, probably need to pack and store it somewhere. One time in my career, the neighbor offered their garage. They regret it later, but one time they offered. Usually it goes to the storage or the new home. If it talks, then the garbage and disposal is involved. Depends how much of treasures we are talking about here. And a donation also, it has to be packed somehow, either garbage bags or boxes, if it's dishes or something, and delivered to the donation center. There's furniture banks. There is something, somebody else who collect big pieces, but I had few bad experience with those people. Some of them require furniture to be stored at the curb. A client would like to do that because they think they're doing a good thing, because they are most of the time. And then people do not pick it up on time, and it's a rainy day or snowy, and then it's a pile of garbage, and they have to spend a lot of money to get rid of it before they open one day, right? It's just to be careful, make sure whoever you're talking to, that they really, I always suggest, start from friends, neighbors, call everybody. If they want to take anything, give it to them, they will remember you for whatever reasons. Don't think that it's very, if it's a treasure to you, it doesn't matter if it's a treasure to anybody else. The saddest story, when we had estate houses and you go through that linen cabinet and the lady's gone, kids want just money, they want to sell the house, they don't want to even, you know, spend their time and thoughts on that. And you go through the cabinets and there is new linen, packed, never used, tablecloths, like some china sets in boxes, you know, that too special, for special occasion. Probably cost a lot of money too, because it was bought like 50 years ago. Cost a lot of money for special occasion never came, and now it goes to the donation or bin, because it had nobody come. And it's a sad story, so no special occasion in your life, guys. I hope you will learn something from here. Your life is a special occasion, today is a special occasion, everything you touch at home should bring you joy. And this is not because I am selling you that, it's experience, and a lot of experience. Okay. Type of staging services offered by your brand. So first is a staging consultation. I would say staging consultation is for budget sensitive client. Well, they want something from you all the time. They want something from you. They know that staging, the big word, very important. Consultation, if I know how to do, I will do it myself. We just take money for nothing. Just tell me what to do. I have a neighbor who is a good mechanic and his wife is a hairdresser. Together we will put something there. Just tell us what to do and where to put the lamp. And if you can pay for that, it would be wonderful, right? So this is the kind of easiest and cheapest way. If your client really wants something, and I have many agents who do just that. So we come, I open all the doors, I talk to the clients, the closet, the crawling space, I will tell them what I think would be better to remove, how to move the couch, what to add, what to move. And then in 48 hours, I send the report, colors, light fixture, and they can do whatever they want. They are happy they have something. 100% they will not do that. They will do the easiest part. And that's it, because if they know how to, they will do it already. Since they didn't do it by now, they still don't know, unless you tell them to put the couch here and there and there, but it's just a very general thing. There's so many parts missing. So this is one of the things. Decluttering and cleaning. Some houses, not only orders and estate sales, are better empty than clean. And I consider it's a very useful staging in those cases. Just empty and really, really clean it well. That's all. Sometimes they have nice pink carpets, but if the house is quite tired and empty, and there's so much to do in the house, whoever buys the house, I wouldn't have even touched the carpet, because yes, I will take the business, it will cost you a few thousand dollars, because the carpet removed is one part of labor, then I have to deal with the garbage left, right? Then we have to put the bin to put somewhere the garbage, and then you have to really remove the staples and clean the floor, so it will cost a lot. So, is it worth it? And not necessarily always.
Or rearranging and making mistakes. Or organizing clients' belongings and rearranging the furniture.
This is when we come, they have plenty. This is the house I saw yesterday, antique collectors, big house, lots of stuff, lots of stuff. I know they have plenty. We don't need to bring anything. We just have to pack what is too much and rearrange what it is. And they have so many art pieces like paintings, and we will find something. So that would be enough for them. It doesn't benefit the house if I bring another new couch, right? I can. But the house, every house has a style and a color and a something special. So if I bring a new couch to whatever is in there, that might clash with the whole picture. So I'm making money, but nobody is stupid. Tomorrow they will never call me, right? So it's better to do right for the house.
Dressing windows. I like that part of staging. I believe in that. It's my second religion.
You will not believe how big is the difference when you dress the windows. The cheapest way to go, I will show you a picture. First, you either enlarge the window by dressing it right. You cover in perfection whatever might be in the window frame. Or some windows are off, big and small and different heights. So cheapest way to go. We charge with dressing, with staging, we charge 170 plus HST per window, which includes all material, curtains, rod, ends, hooks, and installation. We never take it back, so client sells it with the house. They're happy they have something. They can take it with them to the new home, or they can sell it with the house. From my experience, don't take it, because you don't know with the new home size and length. You might be greedy, but it will go to the garbage. Sell it. Sell it, you will buy the new one with the new home. I do believe in window dressing, the cheapest, the best, the simplest ways of staging. Okay, rearranging client furniture and providing decor. Sometimes they have plenty, but they have really, really not. Need some new pictures, maybe mirror, maybe lamp, something new, then we can do that. And also providing furniture and decor like completed. The mirror, I will stop here just for a second. Please remember and be careful. I don't know if you know, but the mirror reflects it. Some people don't. So don't put it in front of the column, you have two. TVs, you have two. Kitchens, you have two. Just be very careful and aware. Where are you planning to put? I like the mirror, it's beautiful, I just bought it. I know, but it's not good here. Right? It's not good here. It has to be in the right place. And house itself, the room will tell you where is the right place. But just remember that mirror reflects everything. This is the purpose of that piece. Okay, the next one. So, few pictures. The dark. You see them? That was before, that was after. What you see when you walk into the house? It was a high park house, old house. See, people lived there. They had dogs, life, golf passion, and a collection of hats and whatever envelopes and whatever is coming. And then you see kitchen and chairs and another chair and whatever, whatever, whatever. So this is the first what people see. When they live every day, they don't see the green carpet and the red and the blue and all those. So they're used to that, right? And this is what we did. You just remove. Remove it simple. Just declutter it and use what they have. Staging for everyday life is very uncomfortable. Staging is like wearing high heels. I'm telling you, it's beautiful to look at, might not be comfortable to walk or run. But this is what sells, and this is the illusion we create, and this is what brings you the most money. It's in general illusion. That was the kitchen.
You can say it's staged, but there is nothing new or extra involved, right? We just remove whatever people had, empty them completely. And if you can see, we just painted the top cabinets, not even the side, the tops. And this is the same kitchen. Same kitchen. This is another simple decluttering, the simplest you can get. Office on the top floor, downtown. They need everything. He was a musician and this and that. And so there's the stairs, upstairs, you come upstairs, and it's just a lot of stuff, I understand. But when you empty, and if you see, we put the rod much higher, to the right to the ceiling, and the window looks bigger and brighter. Simple, there's not much money involved, but the difference picture-wise is completely different. If you have something like that, then see, just...
Let's get a garbage bin.
It's an excellent after, right? If you have
before like that, then it's an excellent after. You don't need it. No purpose, nothing. That's good enough for people to see.
That was a very special case, but I do believe that people had a mental issue like for generations. And we kept going down in the crawling space in the basement. It was same from their mom and grandma who did the same. So it was just, it was, it's hard. They do have some system in their head, people like that. But just their system do not reflect our ideas. That house had one room.
It was a bedroom.
One room for garbage only. For garbage up to the ceiling. One room for new stuff only. And there was a lot, I don't know who gives credit cards to those poor people, but they kept buying and buying and buying. The open door, you cannot see the light fixture. All full of new and very expensive. But because they were there for so long, and the person was very kind, and she had 7 cats living with her, and she was afraid that something would happen to those cats, she didn't let them out. So everything just... So in this case, this is the best staging you can imagine. Okay. And it's also...
So you kept one picture there? Do you recommend a picture versus...
because otherwise nobody will believe that it's in the same room.
Yeah.
At least, you know, the picture here and that kind of shows that it's still the same. Otherwise, people would be skeptical. Oh. I don't know. Floor was hard to see here. Maybe it was not there. Yeah. So they kept one just to remember, even myself, that it was good enough. Okay, potential buyer will look at an insight. Everything they're planning to buy. So if my client would say, why are you opening that? Who will look in it? It's my private thing. They shouldn't. They should. I'm buying your kitchen cabinets, I'm buying your closet, I'm buying your bathroom cabinet. I want to know what is in there. Right? How much space? Not what is in there. How much space do I have for my life to fit in? And if I open something just falling on me, then it feels like, you know, I might not fit there. So they will open. And some people are curious. Neighbor will open because they don't know, but the buyer will open because they're planning to buy. Another one, carpet story. Not always good to remove, but in this case, see, there is no carpet on the main floor, just stairs and a hall. I don't know why they did it. Maybe it was warmer. It was a two-level household house, two-level, but it's not a basement. And I believe they rented probably lower, because there was a door. And maybe it was quiet. I don't know why they put the carpet, or maybe very much fashionable, and they had some money and good quality that was nice 40 years ago. Not anymore. So to remove the wallpaper and do the whole work was really not worth it and a bit too expensive, because you remove the wallpaper very often, you don't know what is behind, and if it's a plaster, you're facing disaster. That we didn't touch, but we suggested let us remove the door and just this carpet, because it was little, it was not from baseboard to baseboard, but from wall to wall. And look at the huge difference. It's not so yucky, it's clean, simple, beautiful. It's same
not the new floor, but feeling is completely
different. That is also just decluttering and rearranging client furniture.
You might not even think that it is staging, but it's part of the staging.
The result is a staging result, right?
With really good budget.
So there was a storage, playroom, something all together, just packed, removed, and they had a family room to sell to Global Investing. Oh, power of index.
I like the index.
Condo, downtown. I don't know if it's a bachelor or one bedroom, living, dining, and a room with a sliding door. This is the room with a sliding door, closet with a mirror door. It's supposed to go as a bedroom. Bedroom did not have a window whatsoever. More like a walk-in, no window. But this wall was neighboring with the kitchen, and on top, above the kitchen cabinets, they had an opening in the wall, and it was light fixture that was directed to the kitchen on that opening. Probably it could not suffocate there, I don't know why, air circulation. To put the bedroom with no wall and no window, it just really doesn't work well. So what we did, we built a window. We built the window, full dressing. Whatever light is in there, it's a light fixture from the kitchen. We added and directed it inside there and inside there. So it looks like a bedroom. And when you walk in there, it's like cozy. So
was there opening or was there opening at the top?
Opening, just the hole, opening.
Uh-huh. So
like a kitchen cabinet, above the kitchen cabinet, there is an opening size of that light fixture.
And because the kitchen had a window.
That's it. Kitchen. So that was the area. It was kitchen, living, yeah. Dining, right? You walk into the kitchen, whatever, and on the side there is a room with nothing that's supposed to be a bedroom with a hole on top.
It's because of the light.
Yes.
Because of the light. Yeah.
I don't think we got much light in there. I think more air circulation. The light did not come from that kitchen. So the air circulation and the light you see on pictures. It's an extra light fixture we put above the kitchen, just to give the feeling that there's some somewhere or something. But see how little? Just the window, completely different. Completely. If we do the same without the window, it still will be a set. Well, not even the whole. Another one. Forget about the clutter. We are talking about windows now. People sometimes, not all, but most of the people believe that everything has to match. Like floor, chairs, curtains, so everything has to match. And they shop, they want to match. And if you want to buy matching, people will sell you matching. It's like up to you, right? But on picture, look how, and then with a neighbor house with a wall, like really close, there's nothing, no way. Like you see the bricks. I just want to show you how the small change changed the whole room. The three holes, dark window, because the wall is there, picture, big and matching, and another window. So three small dark spots, right? Whatever you do, day or night, it will be still dark. A little bit lighter red, darker, it just will be okay. So we put the big mirror in the middle, almost the size of the windows, and it looks more coherent. There's no color in the middle. We put the white curtains that a little bit block that wall. You know, you don't get the feeling right away that there is nothing. And light, a little bit more, completely different curtains. And we didn't put them on both sides, just it creates like one big window instead of those three. They don't need anything else. They don't need table dressing. They don't need much. They just need a window. And that tiny budget, huge difference. And the same room on the side from the living space. Because you will see the same style of curtains. If you have open concept, you have to keep them the same, right? window before. Narrow rod, small window, curtains cover like half of the window, blocked by curtains. And everything is tight. We expand visually the window. We didn't have to put any white shear curtains because the view was beautiful, right? And sunny. And a little bit of like two lamps and cushions, that's all we need in that room. And it's already staged. So staging does not mean necessarily like all wood or track of furniture and everything in there. There's different types, and every house and every client will give you an idea what works the best there.
Oh, windows. Windows, client furniture,
and our a little bit of decor. So house, old house. I think it's an injunction somewhere.
How many focal points you have there? Plenty or not?
Right.
Bathroom, and it's a little master bedroom. Any master bedroom, focal point is always a bed. Any bedroom, just bed. It's the biggest piece there.
Biggest, it has to be beautiful, appealing, inviting, something beautiful.
So, when there's many of everything, then you don't know where your eye rests, right? And it's confusing. And on picture, it's not good to.
Blue windows, different shape. There's another window there on that picture you can see. So what we did, we put the bed as a focal point, two side tables, and we dressed all two walls with white sheer because you cannot put anything else. White sheer creates the flare and crispness and freshness. And we cover all the blue, all those like whatever in there, just all covered, and you have your white beautiful bed. Simple, the simplest staging. Client was so happy, she couldn't believe it was possible to have a bedroom like that. She had a little tour there for neighbors and friends and family members to show them how beautiful her bedroom is. I was kind of happy for her, it's nice. It's so good, yeah. Another one, the focal point. Room and house will tell you what works the best. This is the bedroom before, it was a basement, apartment, and such a small things like rearranging two lamps, completely different story. The window looks bigger a little bit, right? The room is more inviting, there is nothing to walk around, because when it's on this side, this space, you cannot sell, it's a dead space. And people will not go there to look through the window. So when you put it that way, then you have the whole space open and to sell. But each room is different. Really just an idea about the types of simple staging preparation. Okay, this is the staging miracle. It's easy. You have an whatever disaster, but empty. You have to deal with a lot. We just put whatever client needs to do. And we talk to the agent. What do you want there? You want dining, breakfast, office, living,
and we try to set it up. It was in a different light fixture, and when a light fixture is nice and it's possible, then you put your mirror to reflect the light fixture. This is another, I like that house. It's a beautiful house. Very, very big rooms. You can ride bicycles. Beautiful big rooms. But clients, when people, they have big rooms, but they didn't know how to fill them up. They still use the furniture the way they use. So this is the room, and they had a queen size bed towards that wall, and that's it. And the rest you just have dancing place or whatever. There's not a tiny lamp. It just didn't work. So by removing everything they had and bringing king size bed is lost in that room. It's such a beautiful big room, lost. And this queen squeezed the whole corner. Windows, again, they are short somehow. You make them bigger by bringing it up. You also put the carpet. It also enlarges the area when it's possible, right? It's a huge room, so you can fill it up as much as you can. Tiny, tiny difference. But to show you that we do quarter, just decluttering, enough of staging. Client's furniture, two lamps or something, also staging. Beautiful result. Because if I bring this bed to those houses, it will not work. So different house and different type of staging possible and still brings you a lot of money. same room. See how busy, I don't know, maybe grandma's couch and everything.
Matching, people like matching, flowers here, flowers there, right?
But how busy for your eye. And I say, if you are in doubt, look at your house through the camera. Camera do not lie. They will tell you exactly what is wrong. So this is what was, and this is what we brought. Same height, different style, different color, a little bit of chachkas. Okay, every corner is important, especially in the condo, right? There's a kitchen, there's something, and a niche. So we put the office here now.
Then you can sell a condo, you have an office in there, it's kind of cool, right? And when people remember, people go through, they remember the table, they remember bed, they remember that, and they remember office, quick, big, big space, right? It can work.
Another terrible usage of gorgeous space. This is before. I think whoever built the house were cheap on windows because it's really, it could be big and nice and then two holes. By putting the mirror in there, again, it reflects something, you have black and black and you just have lost fireplace completely. There's a beautiful design, you don't see it because your eye is distracted with all that what you have. And then comfortable, matching the floor and whatever is matching, but busy and a little bit of art. And it looks so narrow, so cluttered, so busy, so like, it was a very nice house in Kleinberg, modern house, beautiful area. And with But client was, I am grateful to the client, he was open-minded, he's okay with moving stuff out and putting whatever we need to put. So what we did, we just removed whatever is in there because this was a very nice stone, I don't know the stone over there. Bring more light colors, because the floor is heavily orange. Anything you add is still, we do have colors already when we walk into. We don't need to worry what we will bring because we have already something there and we have to look carefully. So we have gray and blue, we have black, we have white, we have red, we have purple. So we have to think, what do we bring? If we bring it like, you know, green to red, then Christmas. And the springtime does not work. So, and that was so orange and red and everything. I had to wash it out a little bit with everything else, but I could not ignore it. So we put like, and this is another side of this room. This is the back. Because the room was so huge. And that house had so many rooms. And you cannot put a couch in every room. And make it family sitting, family sitting, family sitting. So we brought the grand piano. And it's already different to remember. Because you cannot play on that. But for staging, it was really like real. This is the house you have to invest. And it was, but it was a good money price increase. Client was really happy. And this is when better furnished than empty. Sometimes empty is perfect. But in this case, this is empty. And this is the same for furnished. Some chairs, some something, table, pictures, and it's more inviting. In this case, yes, if you stage the house. Okay, process and logistics. On top of my hands, I just show it up. I saw it on picture, I didn't pay attention before, probably it will be on camera too. So how do we, no surprises, no to hit at this fees. Let's say you have a client and you call me. First, I would like to talk to you to get an idea, what do you expect from the house, right? Then we will meet at the client's house. Everybody's welcome, family members, neighbors, agent, whoever wants to be involved. We will sit, we will talk, I will go through the house, look everywhere, crawling space, garage, basement, everywhere. And also, I need to be with the client just to figure out their expectations and their comfort level, how far we can go, how far we can push them. I don't want to kill them before you sell the house.
house, right? And everybody has their, you know, we will do that, but I will never do that, right? And then we have to compromise within that, either with its emotional comfort level, budget comfort level, or they will never let you touch the bed because it's a holy bed, they sleep there and nobody is in there. We have to figure it out during that meeting. I will answer all their questions, concerns, whatever they want to know. And then I will email my report within 48 hours to the client and to you, like describing everything we discussed, like maybe 2 pages, but everything, because English is not my first language. I might misunderstand them. They might not remember what they mentioned, right? So we will spell it out. And if you want to you discuss or change something, you have a list of everything in front of you, right? Then you have something to see and to base and to discuss. If you said, he said, she said, then it's hard to come to the same decision. And then after that email, again, it will be a price for everything you do with them, price and a time frame. And there are no surprises, no hidden fees. This is the final price. Nothing ever will be changed unless the service is changing. But this is not because you have to work longer, because it was raining, or something else, or bin is higher, heavier because it was raining. Doesn't matter. Or client decided to add another room, whatever, it's a final. Which is good to know. So how we build the price? We offer flat rate. So your client knows exactly how much they are paying before we walk into the house to start working. So, but in order to know that, I really have to understand what is involved. So if it's decluttering, if we keep it, then I probably need yes, if we keep it and we keep a label, if it's a garbage, right, then I might need a garbage bin. For me to know the garbage bin, I have to know how much is the garbage. Like how much garbage do you have? And then the size of the bin, right? If it's a small one, big one, long one, 2, 5, 6 bins, I don't know. And then very often some areas and along the park, high park, especially the driveways, are so small that you cannot even park the smallest bin in there, right? You have to either park on the street or one day in and out or a few bins. So that might change the price, affect the price because of the inconvenience. Or you park it on the street, you have to ask permission from the city to park your bin. There are possible ways that I have to know before we start. And if it's a donation, few bags, garbage bag, it's fine. I will take it as is. If you need a truck, then I have to know how much furniture we are taking. Same with organizing, packing materials, movers. Do we need a truck to move your stuff to the storage, or I just need movers in the house for a few hours to move it to the garage, whatever you have, right? And the staging as well. Is it consultation? Is it your furniture, my furniture, all of ours furniture, just a decor? Then after we know all that and the picture is clear, then we can figure out the price. So how it helps, whatever I was talking about, how it helps you and your client. What is in there for you? For the listing agent, you're bigger than you think, because the client will see a team of experts behind you. It's not just you. And even if an agent says the same, and I will say the same, it's a different approach, different voice, different accent, and they finally hear you, right? That's really, maybe this table should go or something, right? Your extended team has an experience, all products and labor power. We will make it happen. Because we come, we do, you have a result. You can list your house definitely within a week or two. If client does it itself, nothing against the client. I probably will do the same if I'm not in the business. We're emotionally attached to so many things that it's hard for them to do it fast. And they work as well. So agent, which is you, are involved in the process without being present in the house all the time. We are there, you people, your team, your ears, your eyes, we are there working for you. You don't have to be there.
And the client also feels that you are there because you know what is going on, but physically you can do something else. You don't have to be. We guarantee complete update and transparency. We agreed on something, and then during the process, the client starts talking with me about some other unplanned ideas. I will contact you right away. We will know it, all of us, and we will decide what to do. I never discuss the price. I never discuss anything related to the selling of the house. It's not my expertise. I always refer back to you. Even if they try to, and they do sometimes, I really don't know. It's not my business. I will never answer those questions.
Also, we take an emotional burden out of your shoulders because we will be dealing with your client stress when basement and closet decision needs to be made, right?
You don't have to. You have enough stress to put the listing and price and everything, all the small things. We will take it out of your plate.
And we are a one-stop shop, build our reputation on referrals. We have 96.4 percent of referrals and as well as clients. Repeating clients, maybe twice, but I have one client who moved four times.
I'm very happy. Over shoulders.
How it helps your client? Okay, they get more money. In decluttering, staging, they said if you invest $500 in staging, it was pure staging with the furniture. With decluttering, every $1 a seller spends, and it's my statistic, I'm not making it up, they get from $3 to $5 back right away with a house. We will advise what works, what not. It, as I said, $1, three, four quarters, don't do that. If it gives you more, then I would suggest to do that way. Sometimes people want to paint and kitchen and floor and everything. You will be living in the middle of renovation. It's not fun. The result, you are not getting as much as you think you will be getting. So it's not even worth it. Sell the house, we will do this, this, and that. Maybe paint the kitchen, you know, front if needed, but not necessarily change the status ceiling. It's very expensive, not necessary. So we are neutral parties, not emotionally involved, so it's easy for us to go, for example, the National Geographic. Okay. Because when people have to say goodbye to National Geographic, we stick with that. It's not just magazines they have. They made plans. They had dreams. They planned to go somewhere with family. They had to, you know, I will retire and I will do it. Or I will do it with my son or with my family. And to tell them that now it goes to the bin, it's not that goes to the bin. All dreams and plans and you know, and a little bit of failure they feel like, right? It's hard. So that's why we're here to help. I will talk about dreams and my people will kick it gently to the bin. Any questions and concerns are addressed right there, so they will not chase you or will not be like lost in the process. And client makes a decision. It's always his decision or her decision. I cannot make a decision, but we work. No caring or lifting required from the client, but I always say decision is yours. And I will not touch or do anything without you knowing. You sit there and we will do it. But I will tell you where your couch will go and the mirror and everything else. But the general decision is for clients and we make it happen. But they cannot. It's a simple way that. Yeah. And this is my contact. Any questions? It's hot
there. Do you generally recommend painting if required, like is that part of your plan usually?
We
do so go around that.
Depends. You know, depends. If it's a you're not always necessarily need to repaint the whole house because we have so many open concepts and the hall goes into the kitchen and into where do you stop? When the living room needs to be painted, where do you stop? You have to go up, up, up. If it's need to be painted, if it's like terrible blue, better to paint, right? If it's like 2 days ago house, it's like olive color, but works well with furniture and everything else, I will stick with windows. I would just dress small decor, and that would painting the house is good. It involves a lot of money. And then people are living in the middle of renovation. It's another stress level you have to handle. Then they, I had an experience when they, it's good when they leave the house and you can do everything, you can do morning, night, but then they said, oh, my kids are coming from school, we have to stop. And they said, there's drugs for everywhere. And then they complain, there's so much dust, we cannot sleep. What can I do, right? Sometimes it's good, sometimes it's better not. You see how bad, how dark, how flexible people are, right? I wouldn't say always, okay, you have to paint. There's so much involved. It's nice and pretty to say you have to paint, but you have to really remember what is before, pack, cover, live somewhere under the cover, sleep in bed, cover the bed, and what is after the cleaning and everything. You just have to like choose your priority, and then you like, there is no golden rule to paint.
As far as like decluttering the space, do you typically, do the clients we have typically tend to use like a storage space to put the stuff, or are there other like options of keeping it still at
the
house?
It depends what they have. Sometimes your pieces could be okay in the garage.
Right.
Everybody knows you're moving, you're whatever.
Right.
But if you have, you open the garage door and this is that, then you cannot sell the garage.
Right.
Then I would say take it to the storage.
Right.
Or we just recommend free storages in the area, either where they are or they are moving to, if they know where they're moving to, and maybe that. Storage is an expensive venue to take, and people have to be experienced. 6 months, nobody takes stuff out of the storage sooner than 6 months. 6 months are the most organized people. So when they put, stage, remove, move, the most organized people. Usually a year or two. The storage space cost, the smallest $200, very small, the biggest $500, and big, not so big, right? So you have to maybe just, we had a client who had an antique table, he really wanted to sell for, I don't know, $3,000, he couldn't find a buyer, he had to go to Vancouver because he had some job contract, then he put it in his storage, he went to Vancouver, 2 years passed, he had paid another $10,000 to the storage. Now nobody will buy it for $15,000 as well, right? Mm-hmm. So just give it common sense, people, common sense. Sometimes you're afraid to say goodbye, still donate it. Donate and garbage. You postpone your decision, it just costs more. Cost more. Very sad example we had with a couple, husband and wife, getting through, going through divorce. They couldn't figure it out. Whatever, they had storage for her, storage for him, and storage for undecided items. I can just imagine how much it cost them, and I'm very excited for the storage business because they probably were it's a costly venue, and you have to remember you pack, you put in a storage, you need to throw in people, you pay for the storage, then you take it out of the storage, and sometimes you don't even remember what is in there.
I was some movers recently, actually it was quite good, that we were looking to store some items and they actually worked out to be half the price of the storage units. They move and they have a facility where they'll move to their facility. And it's not separated, though that's the only thing, and it's really more for longer, not to go in and out like a storage bin, but their cost will way cheaper.
What was storage
all of
that?
Sometimes they have stash in the
truck. They just have a huge warehouse, I guess, and that's the way they do it. But so in the process of moving, you could move the stuff to storage and then leave it until when they decide
right
when to do with
it. But also,
we checked out all the storage.
It depends on the client, because I have had a client who, for example, like to have 24/7 access to the storage, but he wants to add something or take it out. If you are not able to do that, then you're screwed.
Right.
And some storage is even work like an office hours from 9 to 5. Mm-hmm. You have to be really careful when you call them. Some are 24/7, so from 9 to 5 you cannot get into the storage. Storage is careful, it's a minefield. It's a very expensive. they charge your credit card.
When you get that bill.
What do you charge for your consult, your initial?
For staging consultation with the report and everything, it's $290 plus HST.
$290?
Yeah, $290 plus HST. For rest, I have to know what is it.
And do you have your own some accessories and things that you use, or do you go to a rental place?
Some accessories I do. That works more. Some I do, but for bigger the warehouse. I use a warehouse who has 300 couches and 100 tables. You cannot put the same couch in every house.
No. But for accessories, do you have some accessories yourself that you can use too?
Yes.
Because sometimes a lot of places, they just need updating. They're very dated.
Because they make,
it takes, if you remove the stuff, then you just need something to update it to bring it more into the present time.
Yeah,
yes. Sometimes it doesn't take a while.
To make it more sexy.
Right? Yeah.
Because some were more silver, some were gold, some were colors, the black, whatever. But you have to, just update. And then you have 80% of the houses just need a day of rearranging, updating maybe windows. 80%. 20% from my experience, need everything, like everything. Empty everything, 20%. And I'm not pushing to the rest of 80 to do so, because it doesn't matter who is paying. Let's say you are an agent, there is a client. Doesn't matter who is paying. I have two clients. I have to make both of you happy. Otherwise, you will never call me back. Right? So it's just simple like that. We will do the best to the client and to the house. Not to make money tomorrow, today. People feel that you care.
So if you're dealing with a senior's property,
yes,
and a lot of seniors have a lot of old stuff layers very well. The house itself is pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
But is the stuff in it that's what do you generally recommend? Do you generally serve, well it's hard if they're living, but if they're moving out going somewhere. Do you generally sort of remove everything and then do a little bit of, is that your
if they are seniors?
If they're not there, because they can't live in it, they won't be able to live in it.
Yeah,
but if
yeah.
they're moving out, you have
we will
to
see what the house has. They probably have something, right?
Because I ran into that recently, and our option, so we removed a lot of the furniture because she took it with her.
Uh-huh.
Then there were some pieces left. The problem was the pieces that were left were so old-fashioned that you couldn't, it didn't really help sell the house.
Mm-hmm.
It wouldn't really help. You sort of had to take them out. And then start all over because it sort of dated. It made it look like an old person's house, you know, which is not what we wanted to do.
I will see the whole house, right? I always see everything. I don't see just your hair. I see everything, your glasses, everything. It just, my brain works that way. I will see the whole house. What is in there? Floor, ceiling, light fixture, doors, door frames, but everything. And then we will figure it out. What to bring, right? If they need something, maybe we need to paint it. Maybe it's like blue or green and we need to paint before we bring. But I'm careful with painting because when you cover dark colors, I'm okay. I will paint because I make money anyway. But if you cover dark colors, there are more layers involved, right?
Yeah.
And old paint needs a special primer because nothing sticks to that. There are layers and layers. And every layer is another dollar, right? I have to pay the guy. So I'm careful, but if it's under the skin, I'm fine to do it, right? But then we do. We do, but we don't have like big company with painters.
No, you just
so we have sometimes they're busy, sometimes a big or it depends, you have to pre-book it. But if everything let's say okay. Then I would think about bringing some neutral, maybe beige couch, not too modern, not too old, and some modern cushions. Plenty, sometimes perfect. All those terrible old orange couches people have, right cushions, different couch. And I saved a lot of money for a client, one of your agents, townhouse, a few weeks ago, maybe only 2 months ago, didn't know what to do. Staging consultation, orange couch and everything, and the Christmas cushions and all that. So So we just moved the mirror. We put different cushions, which they had in the basement somewhere far away. We just pulled it out, all of that. We put this picture instead of that mirror here instead of there. I didn't bring a thing of my stuff. We just worked with what they had. Miracle. Depends what you have to bring down and what you have to hide and what you want to emphasize. But the house will come with maybe a window dressing. Maybe light fixtures in the studios.
Because windows are expensive, like they're expensive to dress, really.
$170 per window, think about it. How much will cost you to buy a carpet?
It's expensive, unless you buy real cheap ones.
Okay, so for you. You're buying like 50, 60 bucks for a curtain. Then you have those shears, another 30 bucks, right? Then you need a rod and hooks and everything. It's almost over 100. Then you need to install it. If we charge 170 and we do everything and we give it to you, it's free. It's free. And you sell it, client is happy, the result is fantastic. We just do it that way because we do it like with high schools. We don't know what. It's honestly free. People are pushing me to increase the price, but it's really a good bargain and great result. Fantastic.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very, very much for your time.